Emotion versus reason. Hi, I'm Brian Pombo. Welcome back to Brian J. Pombo Live. Now, why would I bring my little friend up here to say hi to us? The main reason is for the shock value of the image that's going to be used as a thumbnail on whatever social media we have this on, having his face. Tell me, is that an emotional response or a reasonable response that someone would click on it? Are they clicking for a reasonable for a reasonable purpose? Probably not. It's more for that the outrageousness of it. It plays to the emotions. Curiosity, certainly. And that's where marketing comes in, is you have to at least acknowledge that people are emotional beings, and that you have to get past the emotion to the higher set of facilities in their brain. But you can't ignore emotion. It's there. You have to use it to your advantage. I'm not saying that you should use emotion, because you could use emotions a very bad way. You can use emotions to manipulate people into purchasing whatever you're selling, your products or services. Or you can use it in a good way, which is to get your point across so that they will purchase properly. You say, well, that seems like a thin line. It can be a thin line, but it comes with your intent. And at the same time, while I always recommend my clients to use more emotion or to play toward the specific emotion that their prospective customers are after, or the state of mind that they're in, I always recommend that they use more of it, because usually they're not using enough. While at the same time, I recommend that they be less emotional personally, because emotions allow us to be manipulated. Emotions allow us to pick the wrong thing. You know, whether someone is physically manipulating you or not, or purposefully manipulating you, there's always a chance that you're going to go the wrong direction if you're being emotional about something. It's just more likely. Whereas if you're being reasonable, meaning just the way you are when you're not in an emotional state. If you're not fearful, if you're not hateful, if you're not lustful, if you're not, you know, wound up, excited in something, negative, positive, if you're wound up about something, you're being emotional. And I always advise against that. That's why one of our three pillars at brianjpombo.com is being reality-based, reality-centered, reality-grounded. Is the actual term that I use the most, is reality grounded. It's being grounded in reality, which is non-emotional. Emotions have their place, but not in the decision-making process. But at the same time, you have to be able to hold that, while at the same time realize that most people just aren't there. Most people cannot get outside. They're in their emotional state most of the day. And it reminds me of this quote. I wrote it down. It's a F. Scott Fitzgerald quote, which I'm sure you've heard of. This quote, it's the test of first-rate intelligence is the ability to hold two opposed ideas in mind at the same time and still retain the ability to function. And a lot of times that's used, I think a lot of times that quote is used in the wrong way. But in this situation, I think it's true. You have to be able to see that emotions have a purpose, but they can't be ignored. For the longest time, I'll tell you where this all comes from. From the longest time, when I first got involved in business, I've always considered myself more reasonable and more logical than most people my age, and which is, I think, mostly a lie that I told myself, but I believed it. And I always saw that people would make wrong decisions when they're in an emotional state, and so I always tried to play to their logical end, tried to play to their left brain, which is considered the logical side of things, and play toward that and ignore the emotional side. And what I found was failure over and over again. I found that what you end up doing is you end up getting into arguments with people who have already made their decision to not purchase from you, or to not get involved with something, or to not support a cause. I was over and over again, I always tried to take the high road and try to logic people through it. But the problem is that people make emotional decisions and then they back it by logic. And so that's when you get in an argument with someone, especially if you're talking politics, you're talking religion, it's almost always the case. They've already made their decision. They've already decided that Trump's good or Trump's bad or whatever it is, that God exists, God doesn't exist, whatever. They've already decided emotionally. And they use every bit of, that's why their logic can go all over the place. When you try and pin them down, they'll jump all over the place because they've already decided. There's no talking them out of it. The reptile brain, the lizard brain, whatever you want to call it, it's already decided. That they talk about that, the reptile brain. It's basically it's where your emotions react in your brain stem. It's the most primitive part of the brain, evolutionary speaking, and it's a good way of thinking about it, because it's the part that moves first. They've taken scans of your brain when you're going through a decision-making process, and long before you think the decision's made, it's already made. You've already decided, and it's on the emotional level. It's just the way it is. That's how most people work. So you can't ignore emotions when you're attempting to persuade, when you're attempting to bring someone over to your way of thinking, when you're attempting to sell a product to them or a service, or trying to get them to look at something a little bit differently. You can't ignore the emotional issues that are going on. But at the same time, you're never going to be able to handle that properly and be able to maneuver your way through that forest if you're not of sound mind and being as reasonable as possible. Hopefully that makes sense. We'll be back again tomorrow with another talk on either principles, strategies, or tactics to help you explode your business from here and beyond. If you're a business owner or executive and you're looking for some help in really exciting your prospects into purchasing more of what you have to sell, then go check out brianjpombo.com/Amazon. That's the Amazon Proof Strategy Session. You're welcome to apply to sign up for that. Not everyone is accepted, but if you qualify, you will be, and we'll have a chance to talk. So go check that out. That link is in the description. We'll be back tomorrow. In the meantime, get out there and let the magic happen.